cloud computing. So we have seen about what is data warehouse. Now cloud computing. So what is cloud computing? Cloud computing is simply, we can say that resources available on internet, right? So cloud simply means resources available on internet. So what are these resources? It may include servers. It may include a storage, a database, networking, your software, what you require for. So everything, whatever you are doing on premises, so that can be done on cloud, right? That means that you are going to access a system which is not in your premises. That is what a cloud computing is about, okay? Simply saying. So what advantages this cloud is having? So for example, if you want a software, we need to run a software. For that, we require 16 GB of memory. For example, I'm telling you, right? 16 GB of memory, which you don't have. You have systems all with 4 GB of memory only. So that time we are hiring a system and using it for a particular time period only, okay? So instead of hiring a system and configuring it in your network, in your own premises, that means you are putting it in your own building and all. So just we are going to hire a system which is in a remote location, right? And we are accessing that system using internet. So that is what a simple explanation about cloud computing. So cloud computing provides you everything, whatever you require for working on your IT department. Okay, so that is what cloud computing is about. So three type of cloud computing is available: application, platform, and infrastructure. So that depends on how much cloud service provider is involved and your involvement. So the ratio between your own involvement and your cloud provider's involvement, right? Infrastructure as a service means the cloud provider will give you just hardware and software and all, right? And they provide you a hardware, for a machine with a particular amount of memory, a particular amount of the CPU process and all, right? So this machine can be accessed from your own premises through internet, and you will be able to load your own software and you can work on that one from there, okay? So that is what infrastructure as a service is about. Platform as a service, the cloud vendor will provide both the hardware and software, only which some of the software which you are having as a customized one, that only will be, you need to load it into the cloud system and you can work from there, right? And the management of the software, the tuning of them, optimization, everything else, you have to do it. When you talk about the software as a service, the vendor provides both hardware and software and management also. That is what important here. So you don't need to worry about the licensing. You don't need to worry about any updation to be done. You don't need to worry about the security process, right? Protection, backup, everything else will be done by the cloud vendor, okay? So that is what software as a service. So obviously Snowflake is a software as a service only, right? It falls under the software as a service type. So what is the advantages of cloud? Flexibility, scalability, right? So you can, if your business grows, you want to upgrade your systems, that can be done immediately. Within minutes, you can do it in a cloud environment, okay? So that is what scalability. And sometime later, you feel that your business is not up to that level and you the customers are not logging in that much of time. So you can reduce your IT environment also, right? So that is what the scalability is about. Scale up or scale down can be done in a very simple manner. And the reduction of cost will be that, because you don't need to pay for every hardware you are providing, right? So whenever you are using some hardware, we need to provide it in upfront. So we have to purchase it or we need to hire it and all. And once we have used them, we need to keep it without any return on investment will be there, right? So the cost reduction will be there because we are not owning anything, but we can use all these resources up to the level, right? Then easy implementation. So as I said, any hardware, software, networking, databases, anything else, we don't require to install that on premises. And one thing is, we don't need the hardware setup physically, and we don't need the expertise resources for doing this stuff also. Okay. That is what been done. Then management is also easy because most of the management is done by the cloud provider itself. And accessibility, that is what we call it as mobility. So where these resources, these systems can be accessed from anywhere, even from your laptop or even from your mobile, and from any geographical location, it is possible. Only thing, you need to have a internet connection, right? So you don't need to come to your office to a particular location for a data center. Anything else is not required. So if from anywhere with a proper internet connection, you can work on this, because the configuration of the system, what you are connecting with, is not considered here, right? So it is just for connecting. Everything else, all these process will be done with the cloud systems only, right? And similarly, efficient recovery. So fast and accurate retrievals of application and data. So whenever you are having any disaster happens, so or any power surge is happening, right? So either by nature or by man-made disasters. So everything, whatever you are having there, that your valuable data will be safe. So that is what the efficient recovery will be there, right? So by default, every cloud provider will provide you a disaster management system. Then we have some disadvantages also. Vendor lock-in will be there, but that means if you are going for any one of the vendor, you cannot just move to another vendor and take all your resources over there. So not easily possible. Similarly, the connectivity depends upon your local connections, local powers, right? So that is what the connectivity is about. Then you will be having a limited control over your resource, own resources, right? So that is obvious, actually. Even though you have removing the headache of maintaining everything, so you have to depend more on your cloud provider, okay? So that is what dependency is about. Security and downtime. So even we have a very tight security available on every cloud provider's environment. Sometime, very rarely, it may occur, right? So the security breach can happen at any point of time. We know that even our Facebook or even WhatsApp messages also can be interrupted by some hackers, right? So that can happen over here. So these are the disadvantages, but these are all negligible.